Hello friends, welcome back. So today's video is on let's check if you are brainwashed about India. So guys, we are from India, so I don't think we would be brainwashed.
Right.
But I guess she's talking about all the people that are outside of India, right. The outside world. Are they brainwashed about India? So let's just jump into this video.
Many of you have seen people of Indian origin in your country. How do you perceive them? And how do you perceive India? Many of you think of India as a country of poverty, slums, dirt, rapes, and caste system. And many of you got introduced to India through the famous movie Slumdog Millionaire.
Oh yeah, this was a popular one.
There are some of you who know India for its Bollywood and yoga.
Yoga is very popular, yeah.
Well, it is not entirely your fault that you think this way. And there is no doubt that India does have its imperfections. But India is definitely not what we are shown in our countries. Like many of you, I was also a victim of the mainstream media in my country until I ended up living in India and started to keenly observe this country. And of course, to understand India and its mechanism, one really needs to have fine-tuned senses.
Mm-hmm.
Next time you see Indians in your country, remember that their country is being transformed into something like this.
Mm-hmm. This is Murgaon.
You are mostly shown only that. Mm-hmm. And of course, many of you were never told that for many years, India has been one of the fastest growing major economies of the world.
Right.
Are you worried that Indians are stealing your jobs in your countries? No, you are not fully informed. Perhaps you do not know that Indians are also providing thousands of jobs in your country.
Yeah.
And they are doing it in different parts of the world. There are more than 800 Indian companies in the UK, which employ around 110,000 people. In the USA, Indians-owned firms employ more than 600,000 employees.
Mm-hmm. That's impressive.
Have you noticed that when the media in the West talks about rapes in India, they rarely talk about the rape rate statistics? And probably it is because India is nowhere close to the Western countries in rape rate.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I'm aware that while talking about rape, one must consider things like underreporting, marital rape, homosexual rape, false filing, law of rape, conviction rates, and many other factors. And that is why I sincerely recommend you to dig a bit deep into this and analyze where your own country stands before you become a victim of the mainstream or fake stream media.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, were you also told that the so-called developed countries do not only have a much higher rape rate, but also their citizens travel abroad to rape the citizens of poor countries? Europe, North America, Australia, New Zealand are some of the main sources of international child sex tourists who perform sex crimes in other countries. Were you also told that many Western women travel abroad to enjoy female sex tourism? And it is difficult to believe that the boys who are hired by these rich women are in some cases not underage. India has always been a multicultural society. And yes, in one way or another, discrimination may exist in India too. But wait, which country is crime-free? Is your country crime-free?
Mm-hmm.
Is there no discrimination in your country?
Every country has it.
India is a country where its minorities are allowed to thrive and grow in numbers,
mm-hmm.
and also in percentage. India is a country where many Dharmic traditions like Jainism, Sikhism, Buddhism and Hinduism were born. And the people of India have even accommodated the ideologies and religions that did not originate from their own land. When I first heard of Indian caste system in my country through our media, it was not even mentioned that in India, not only the minorities, but also the members from those societies which are also known as low caste, end up becoming presidents, vice presidents, prime ministers, and chief ministers. Has the media in your country told you about this when they talked about Indian caste system to you? Has the media in your country also mentioned that India has already had a female president and a female prime minister? I know that in many so-called developed countries, many low-skilled immigrants from poor countries are purposely and temporarily brought to do low-class and dirty jobs. These poor people are kept in substandard conditions, and after the job is finished, they are sent back to their own countries. The developed countries make the most of their strong currencies, and their own citizens shy away from doing small jobs. Well, these developed countries are so smart that they perform oppression on the humans that they import, and then later, very cleverly, they dispose them. Can we call it exploitation too? Indians are extremely self-critical, and they are genuinely concerned about their problems. They do have the intentions to fix their problems, and they do not shy away from talking loud against their democratically chosen governments. But you must remember that when Indians talk loud about their problems, it does not mean that they want to replace India for anything else. And it must be pointed out that Indian media has not really started ridiculing the Western countries yet, even though many Western countries love to present themselves as some kind of role models. These Western countries continue to forget that they can also easily be ridiculed for their wealth inequality, crimes, intolerance, rapes, poverty, and even hunger. Perhaps Indians are more interested in self-correction than ridiculing others. For sure, Indians know very well that tragedy is not a competition. Indians are not only providing jobs around the world, they are even feeding many hungry and poor outside India by their philanthropic work through their temples and gurudwaras. And very importantly, they are not expecting anyone to embrace Buddhism, Jainism, Sikhism, or Hinduism. There is no doubt that India does need to improve its modern waste management infrastructure, as many of its streets continue to look dirty, even though an average Indian produces far lesser waste than an average American
population
and
European. That's right.
Also, the per capita emissions from India are so low in comparison to the USA or China. And Indians are nowhere close to the West when it comes to historical emissions. For all these years, you were told about the poor sanitation of India, but you were never told that Indians were also the pioneers
in
the ancient sanitation system long before the Western countries got civilized.
Correct.
But of course, it shouldn't matter today. Even after 70 years of its independence, India is still not open defecation free. The government of India is running some massive scheme to build millions of toilets, and only time will tell if that is going to be enough or not. Not many people know that when it comes to defecation, some citizens in the Western countries have a strange addiction, or rather a disorder, and this is where a potential exchange can take place between India and the West. India can bring the latest sanitation system techniques from the West, and the West can benefit from the authentic yoga from India that can help those Western citizens who are suffering from such disorders or addictions. But of course, it can only happen if the Western societies are brave enough to address their embarrassing problems and not just sweep them under the rug, as it is very well known that such kind of disorders and addictions have been reflecting in the Western adult film industry as well. Not many people know that India has nuclear weapons, and it is said that India has the fourth strongest military in the world.
The fourth or the third?
India does not believe in China or the USA, and neither it believes in expansionism. And yes, India is not a world leader in everything. It's not a world leader in earning money by selling weapons. It stands nowhere when it comes to earning money by selling crude oil. However, its space agency, ISRO, does earn money by sending satellites in space for a very cheap price, fulfilling the satellite dreams of poor countries, and also by helping the advanced countries which want to save money. India is not a leader in the porn industry, and neither it is a top destination for sex tourism. Mostly, Indians are just very simple and kind-hearted people, and only some of them know that their land was the richest in the world for thousands of years, and it was gradually pushed into poverty.
Being only some know, not all of them.
And colonized by its invaders and colonizers. And these unfortunate victims, who have just tasted their independence after centuries of oppression and atrocities, are finally rebuilding their country
again,
in an extremely democratic environment that may slow down things a bit for them, but at least their system attempts to involve everyone in the rebuilding of their nation. The good news is that India's rise is unlikely to cause any country a demographic trouble, as India's Dharmic institutions are not interested to convert you from your religion. Not just that, we are not really going to face any brown supremacy, even though Indians themselves come in all skin colors and features. It is also highly unlikely that Indians will hate you, even though many of you may have developed prejudices against them because of the mainstream media houses, which for some special reasons are overplaying and sensationalizing their problems. Indians are gentle, accommodating, compassionate, hospitable, and yes, they do not have a fake smile. Their smiles are still very real. And most importantly, they are forgiving. Look how they even welcome the people from the land of their ex-colonizers in their country, even today. Before you comment on India, remember that the countries which were never colonized will not easily understand what it means to suffer from a post-colonial identity crisis. India may have its imperfections, and in this process of rebuilding, it will make its share of mistakes, and it will learn from them. Perhaps we also need to learn how to build a relation with Indians on equal terms, with mutual respect, without feeling superior or inferior, while focusing a bit more on ourselves to address our own embarrassing problems. See you again.
That was a very nice video, beautifully said, and some of the things I could totally relate to. Especially when they said, you know, generally what people think about India, because they've been brainwashed, and that is mainly due to media. And we've discussed this before too, like in movies and stuff, Hollywood movies, the way they project India with slums and cows and dogs and poverty, or, you know, uncleanliness and stuff like that. But that's not actually India. I mean, that is India long, long time back. And now India is developing. So definitely, yes. So, and when they talked about, you know, India is not a land of snake charmers, this just reminds me of the speech that Mr. Modi gave, where he said that Indian Americans are, the credit goes to them, because they have been able to get rid of this belief that the Americans or the outside world had about India being a land of snake charmers, because now you're showing the world by being in different fields like IT or, you know, other fields, that we are not a land of snake charmers, we are land of brainy people. So that's exactly what, you know, when she talked about it, reminded me of. So beautiful video, lots of information in here. And definitely a watch for the outside world, so that they realize that what they're thinking about India is not 100% true.
Right. You know, one of the things that I like the most in this is that she said that Indians are very kind.
Oh, yes.
And that is true, because Indians by nature, you know, they like everyone. Like, they don't care about the skin color, or they don't care about anything. When you come here or you go anywhere, you, when you're smiling at them in reality, right? And you're a happy person. You don't, you know, have any racism at all. I mean, no Indian would have any racism when you come here out of anything, right? You're happy-going people. They are nice people. They're helpful people. Everywhere you go and see, you know, there are people are helpful. You know,
and forgiving.
Yeah, forgiving. They're helpful, and they are very kind-hearted people. That is the other fact of life. And she went through the video, shows many of the sceneries of India, and if somebody looks at that, they'll think, hey, is this China or is this some other Singapore? The good part is, no, it was really India. It was, they were showing Gurgaon, and the Gurgaon was looking like any other city on earth. So, but and there were a lot of things, you know, that the video goes over, you know, that the India is growing up. And but one thing they said, that India, all the people of India know that they were once the richest country in the world. So they are still in that, okay, we were the richest country in the world, we'll get there, we are getting there. And that gives some kind of confidence and strength, and you're good. And again, very nicely, she, you know, she's trying to say, what does brainwash means? Brainwashing, what does it mean? It really means that if I keep showing you the same clips about India, if I keep showing you same things about India, you will think, okay, that's how India is. And that is the issue with the media. The media, not Indian media, the Western media. The media over here portrays India like that. Maybe because they're uneducated. That's why sometimes, you know, when my colleagues, or when I came long time ago, you know, people just were thinking, hey, is India like this? I said, and I told them, you know, if India is like that, then how come I can, you know, do a better job than you? Right? I mean, who taught me? You know, how can I do the same thing faster than you? And how can I do better than you? How come I have least amount of bugs? So how can I do all that? Do you really think a land of snake charmers can teach a guy to do that? So then they really had to think about it, that, you know, looking at all the people that are coming from India, they are doctors, they are engineers, they're in great positions. Then how can India be a land of snake charmers? How did they learn that much? How did they know more than us? How are they good in math and science? So the good part is, people here finally realized that all the people that are coming, they are able to do such great things better than us. So most likely they are coming from a very modern place. And that's the reason nowadays, because there's so many companies in India that are opening offices here, and the companies over here are opening offices, so people get a chance to visit India. So when they get a chance to visit India, then they realize, okay, I can see that they are not the way I was thinking. They're very cool people. They're very kind people. They're very gentle people. They're respectful people. And slowly, yes, I mean, a person who has been going, he can see the airports are coming up, the infrastructure is coming up. So they can see, okay, I mean, everything, there is nothing that you cannot get in India. Anything that you need is available in India. So you can get it in India. You have poor people, you have super rich people, all sorts of people. But in spite of all that, people are kind. They are happy. You know, they are going to give a real good smile. And whoever goes will feel that
they'll
beauty.
Feel at home.
Yeah, I mean, life is tough, no doubt, because of population, life is tough. But in the end, right, the essence of India, you learn about. And that's the reason now many people over here, they understand what India is, because they have looked at the people of coming from India, and they themselves have gone. Right? Because the world is not a closed knit now. It's very easy to go to India and come back nowadays. So that's why people are traveling more, they're getting to it, and then they also wonder. But the media also here is changing. The media is changing. No longer in the media, India is being portrayed in a bad fashion. I mean, I sometimes do see, you know, some cases that she was saying something happens in India, they'll highlight that. So there are some newspapers, there are some media outlets, they are biased towards everyone. I mean, those newspapers, they're in the business of being biased, because I know some, I don't want to name them, but everybody knows there's some newspapers, they always show something bad about India. So that is the newspaper's problem. And as the people of India over here are going to do great, or people of India all over the world are going to do great, it is going to change the mindset, and nobody will buy it. People say, no, I don't think so. What you're saying is all crap, because I know this guy who's better than me. I know this doctor who's a genius. I know this guy who's a fantastic. So I don't think I agree with you. Right?
Exactly. So yes, guys, beautiful video, eye-opening for all those people who have been brainwashed. So, and good thing is, once again, it's in English, so no knowledge barrier can be easily understood by all outside of India. So once again, a beautiful suggestion, loved it. And now we'll take our leave, and we'll come back again with another video pretty soon. Till then, take care and bye-bye.
Oh, and if you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit the bell icon so it notifies you when I put in my new video for you to enjoy. Bye!